Alright, this is a video response to Concordance and his video on raw milk. First off, I'd like to say a huge fan of Concordance. Always love your stuff that you produce. I wish you'd produce a lot more because I always tune in as soon as I see that you make a new video, so huge fan. This is a response to his three situations where we are attempting to justify government intervention in people's lives and the issue of liberty. And I'm going to borrow a lot of my arguments from John Stuart Mill, who was a 17th century British philosopher who dealt with the exact same topic on the limits of government and on the express powers of a free government that protects human liberty while maintaining the liberty of everyone involved. And it's usually classified as a utilitarian argument, and it, rightly so, it is a utilitarian argument. So you can criticize it on that grounds, but otherwise I think it's utterly valid. The first situation I think deals with a situation where a woman was peddling a cure for cancer that was just alcohol, rubbing alcohol, which is obviously dangerous to your health if you try and drink this stuff. And you can justify government intervention in those rounds by saying this woman does not have the right to intentionally deceive people for profit. That is, she does not have the right to go out and purposely harm people simply to get their money, and that the only mechanism by which other people can actually, you know, seek redress against this woman is through legal means, through the government intervention. We have the FDA for the same reason. You know, you'd look at consumer safety laws, especially in the United States, where we have a system of regulations put in place to ensure that companies or individuals selling goods are selling the things that they actually say they're selling. Like a drug company can't sell you a drug company can't sell you a cancer remedy that turns out just to be a placebo pill. That's just a sugar pill. It has to sell a safe product, and it has to market and advertise it correctly. You know, you get instances in the past few years of where you had the lead paint issue, and the FDA stepped in to stop shipments of this. Yes, it did restrict their liberty, but the reason it restricted their liberty was that these companies were intentionally deceiving their consumers, and that presented a public safety risk. And the government obviously has a right to intervene in issues of public safety. The second situation he brings up really deals with, I think, is not a cut and dry issue. It deals with a company selling a mild hallucinogen that apparently is simply a recreational drug, though I'll have to ask for clarification whether it has any medical use whatsoever or if it's simply a hallucinogen, as this is a very important aspect. The situation, as far as I understand it, is the company's selling a mild hallucinogen, and it's not effectively regulated, so it gets into the hands of children, and a small percentage of adults taking it receive adverse side effects. In this situation, I would have to say that that doing a simple cost-benefit analysis yields the result that the company should be allowed to sell this product, but that the sale of that product should be regulated, as with the case of any prescription drug. I mean, you look at the situation, the prescription drug, you know, situation we have in the United States, where a company is literally prohibited from selling a drug without the consent of a person's doctor, which is performs a very, very useful safety check against the sale of unlawful prescription drugs. I mean, you look at some of the drugs out there that have been produced certainly in certain years to combat neurological disorders, and these drugs are extremely dangerous if you take them in the wrong dosage or if you give them to the wrong people with certain, you know, genetic predispositions. So I think that the situation in this government intervention is not justified in completely abolishing the product, but government intervention is justified in limiting the sale of the product to only those people who would benefit medically. The last part deals with heroin consumption, sale, transportation, and the government justifications for prohibiting this. And I think these three situations or scenarios really deal with a continuum of three different situations where you could argue government intervention is not justified, government intervention may be justified, and government intervention is extremely justified. And I think this last situation is a situation where government intervention is extremely justified, and the reasons are strictly utilitarian. I think the argument that would be that government has a vested interest in keeping its population healthy and safe, and that part of that is prohibiting and controlling the use of substances that would run contrary to this end. Namely, weed. In American society, we do not allow people to drive drunk because that presents a significant risk to themselves and to other people. We do not let people drive 120 miles an hour, even sober, down the freeway because most people are not trained to drive at such speeds, and the cars are simply just not built to handle at those speeds. And it also presents a significant risk to themselves and other people. We don't allow people to talk on cell phones while driving. You'll notice all my examples are with driving because that's a very, very key safety issue within modern society. Well, anyway, we don't let people drive and talk on cell phones for the exact same reason, as it poses a danger to themselves and to other people. So I think the reason that we don't allow heroin in the United States, or any similar hard drug like cocaine, heroin, acid, you know, LSD, anything really harder than pot, which is, I think, a completely separate issue. We don't allow them to do these things because it poses a significant risk to themselves. I have met no one so far. I have yet to meet someone who proposes the idea that heroin use is medically beneficial, mostly because it's proven to not be, and I think you would have to argue very hard and very long to convince anyone that it is. It poses a significant health risk to themselves, and there can be a case to argue that it poses a significant health risk to other people. I mean, you have someone walking down the street who's whacked out on heroin or cocaine or LSD or shrooms. This would pose a significant public health risk. And I think that's the fundamental component of any argument dealing with controlled substances, is that the government has a justification. Its case is justified in preventing the individual liberty when there is a significant public safety risk or a significant personal safety risk. That is, you can limit. You have the absolute freedom to do whatever you want until that freedom impinges upon the safety of yourself or other individuals. I think that's the core component, and it's a strictly utilitarian argument that the cost to society for allowing this type of behavior to continue is greater than the benefit to personal liberty that we get out of this issue. All responses are set to automatic approval. I hope to get some conversations going. Thanks for watching.